reaction to all of this, the draft that has been circulated, that we think the president may bring out something that looks quite a bit like this. Hassan Shibli is chief executive director at the Florida chapter of the Council on American Islamic Relations. Good to have you with us tonight. Good evening, sir. What are your thoughts, you know, as you look at what you've heard so far in this plan? What do you think?
Trump's policies are bad for America. They appear to be amongst the first of many discriminatory policies that disadvantage America first and foremost and hurt our fellow human beings after that. One of the greatest Americans who passed away not long ago, Steve Jobs, is the son of a Syrian immigrant. Where would America be and what would it be missing had we not had Steve Jobs immigrate to America?
The point of this draft, and if you go through the language and read it, it's not about permanently keeping people out of the country, and it doesn't affect people who are in the country already. What it talks about is trying to vet properly. So, you know, under the scenario that you just presented, nothing would have prevented that person from getting into this country.
And that's exactly right. And this scenario that we've had, it works. Refugees are the most vetted people in the world. It often takes them about 24 months of vetting before they're able to come to America. And that's why statistically, you have a lot less crime, murder, and even terrorism coming out of refugees. In fact, statistically, the chances of being killed by a refugee is 1 out of 3.6 billion.
We've all seen the issues that are happening in Europe. We have seen why there's so much concern to make it more difficult for the flood of refugees to go through. Everyone is sympathetic to the needs of good, you know, people who want to leave their country, and we all understand why they want to leave those countries. But, you know, just going through some of this draft language, it says, you know, that people would be blocked, have their access blocked if they engage in acts of bigotry, hatred, honor killings, violence against women, and persecution on the basis of religion, race, gender, or sexual orientation. Can you agree that you would not want...
Yeah, that's already there, of course, but it goes far beyond that. It completely bans Syrian refugees and potentially completely bans any immigrants. Yes, for a time.
Until the immigration process is refined to a point where the administration feels it's satisfactory. I mean, the underlying crux here is that you want to keep people out of the country who want to do harm or who are potential criminals. That's what everyone's talking about here.
And we all agree with that.
Or whether it's coming from Middle Eastern countries, it's the same aim, is to keep people safe in their country. Doesn't every country want to do that?
Right, but these policies aren't aimed at that. What they actually do is not make America safer. They just promote fear and hatred. You know, the chances of being killed by your clothes burning is greater than your chances of being killed by an immigrant. The chances of you being run over by a railway car is greater than chances of being killed by an immigrant.
Well, that's precisely why you have protective measures to protect from those things as much as we possibly can as
And
well.
We support the basic protective measures, absolutely.
And you want to protect from these issues as much as you possibly can as
absolutely. Well. Absolutely. I just think Trump's position is too extreme, yes. But these positions are too extreme, and it's important we don't lose who we are as Americans. America's a nation built on diversity, built on immigrants, and we have to remember our enemies can never defeat us. We can only defeat ourselves if we allow fear and hate to turn us against each other and be willing to promote discriminatory policies.
And I think these policies go too far. People from entering the country,
Trump was on the record saying he wants to ban all Muslims, so it's scary. But thank you for having me. God bless you. God bless America.
Thank you for being here.